Well, good morning. Happy Friday. If you hear me clap once, if you hear me clap twice. Woo! We are ready to go. The sun is shining. And I got to tell you, in this front row here, I have a lot of good looking boys and girls. And you know, I got a sneak preview yesterday of them practicing in their classroom. And they were fabulous. What I'd like to do, all first grade parents, you're more than welcome to stay in the back. If you would like to move to the sides and stand to videotape or to check things out a little closer, you're more than welcome to do that. Along the walls, though, the wall sides. Yep, the walls are perfect. All right. Hopefully everyone can get a good picture of their son or daughter. Well, our verse this year, where's it from? John what? John 13, verse 34. So let's say this together. A new command I give to you, that you love one another, just as I have loved you. Amen. Great job, everyone. At this time, I would like to pass this on to Mrs. Smith. Are we ready to go? Okay. Thank you.
The king of the lions, my God's the king of the creatures of the deep, my God's the king of me. Have you heard the story about my friend King Dave? Wouldn't let the giant stand in his way. He said, hand me my sling, cause he's not that tall. My God is bigger and I watch him fall. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. Have you heard the one about this guy called Dan? Yes, he was a mighty holy praying man. They said throw him to the den of the scary beasts, but God saved a hero from the lion's teeth. Yeah. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. This is more than history. You will do the same for me. Like Jonah and the whale at sea. When I'm lost and afraid, all alone in the dark, you're with me. Oh, you're with me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. My God's the king of me.
We trust, in you, Jesus. You're all, you're all that we need. Your power will pull us through. We're trusting in you, we're trusting in you. You give us hope and life that's forever. You make us bold and we stand together. On this journey, there's no looking back. With Jesus to lead us, we're on the right track. Oh, 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 oh. vacant spaces for wide open eyes. We're looking ahead for the next big surprise. Oh, 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 oh. We trust, we trust, we trust in you, Jesus. You're all, you're all, you're all that we need. Your power will pull us through. We're trusting in you, we're trusting in you. This journey, there's no looking back. With Jesus to lead us, we're on the right track. Oh, 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 oh. Wide open spaces for wide open eyes. We're looking ahead for the next big surprise. Oh, oh, oh.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to First Grade Chapel. Mackenzie is going to start our morning with praying for us.
Please bow your heads and close your eyes. Dear God, thank you for bringing us to school today. Thank you for Calvary Academy. Thank you for the day. Please bless our chapel. We love you. Amen.
Our speaker today is Will Ryan, and he was one of my own kids' youth pastor, and he is now the youth pastor at Crossroads Church in Sherrillville. He is married, and he has one little tiny boy named Silas. So I'm going to welcome Will up to the stage, and he's got some messages to share for us on love. Welcome, Will.
Thanks so much. All right, guys. Well, hey, it's so good to be with you. How are you doing this morning? Good, good. Like Mrs. Smith said, my name is Will. I work in Sherrillville at a church called Crossroads Community Church. I'm the youth pastor there. It's really fun. I like it. And also, like she said, I am married. I have a son. I have some pictures for you. So this is my wife, Liz, and that's my son, Silas. He is he's like 6 or 7 months. So he's getting pretty big. This morning he woke up at 6, and he normally doesn't wake up at 6 and just screamed for a while. So that was fun. But he's a good little dude. I like him. I also have a cat. I got a picture of my cat. Yeah. His name is Phineas. He's a funny little dude. Yeah, Phineas. But yeah, I know we don't have a Ferb, which is upsetting. We thought about naming our kid Ferb, but we felt like that would be weird. So no Ferbs in our house, but it's fine. Today, you guys, we are going to keep talking about, we're going to talk about your theme verse. So I have your theme verse. Let's read it together. Then we're going to get into it. So here it goes. Ready? Start here. A new commandment I give to you. All right, so we're thinking about love, right? We're thinking about Jesus says that his commandment is that we love one another, right? Let me ask you a question. How many of you would say that you want to do the right thing in life? Yeah? Generally? All right? I think so. I want to do the right thing in life too. I try to all the time. But I'm talking like you want to obey your parents, right? You want to do what they say. You want to be a good person. You want people to think you're nice, right? And I think that's right. And even if most of the time we don't always choose to do the right thing, we want to be a good person, right? Yeah? I think we want to be a good person generally in life. But I think being a good person is a really good thing, and it's something we should try to do. But do you think your attitude matters when you're trying to be a good person, yes or no? Okay, yeah, I think your attitude matters too. Like, if your mom or dad tells you to do the dishes or to do something, and you do it angry, are you still being a good person in that moment? That's interesting. So if you do the right thing, but you do it with a bad attitude, is that a good or a bad thing? Are you still being a good person? All right. I want to read some scripture and I want to talk about this because I think this is a really interesting thing that we need to talk about. So I'm going to read you a passage from the book of 1 Corinthians. All right. And the writer, whose name is Paul, he's talking about why being a good person matters, all right? So it's going to be up here on the screen. This is 1 Corinthians 13, starting in verse 1. He says, if I speak in human or angelic tongues, but I don't have love, I'm like a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and I can understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so that I can move mountains, but I don't have love, I'm nothing. And if I give away all my possessions and I give my body in order to boast, but I do not have love, I gain nothing. So what's he saying, right? He's saying that if you say super wise or super nice things or super smart things, but you don't have love, you're like a gong. Does that make sense? That's kind of silly, right? A gong. If you are the smartest person in the world who knows everything, but you don't have love, what do you get? Nothing. Nothing. You get nothing. And if you give away everything you have to people who need it more than you, if you give away everything you have so that you've given away everything, what do you have if you've given away everything but you don't have love? Nothing. Exactly. Now, does anybody know what a gong sounds like? Yes. Yeah? All right. Well, for those of you who don't, I'm going to show you. Mrs. Smith, do you have a volunteer for me? Okay, cool. Give her a round of applause while she comes up here. What's your name?
Alaysia.
What's it?
Alaysia.
All right. Alaysia is going to ring this gong for us so that we all are on the same page about what a gong sounds like. Ready? Use this and ring it as loud as you can. All right, go. Try again. That was really quiet. Very nice. All right, give her a round of applause. You can go sit back down. Hey, high five. Oh. All right. That was kind of a wimpy gong, but it was $10 on Amazon. So, like, what you gonna do? Now, a gong makes a noise, right? It sounds like something, but it doesn't really sound like anything. It's just noise. It just, like, gets your attention. It tells you that something's happening, but it doesn't really do anything. That's what it's like to live your life without love, all right? And I think what God is telling us through these scriptures, through 1 Corinthians, is that our attitude and our hearts really, really matter. The way we do things, the attitude that we have, the way we treat people, that really matters. One day, I was like probably 13 or 14. Is anybody in here 13 or 14? Nice. All right. Yeah. So you guys ever fight with your parents? Yeah. I was so mad at my mom one day. I was really mad at my mom. And we're having a fight, and I decided that when my mom and I are having this fight, I was going to clean the kitchen. So I did all the dishes. I wiped all the counters. I changed the trash. I did everything. And I fought with my mom the whole time. And I did this because I was like, I mean, it sounds kind of silly, right? Like I'm doing something nice for my mom while I'm being angry at her. But I did it because I was like, oh, you know, I'm doing all these nice things for her. So if she tries to get mad at me, I'll be like, why are you going to be mad at me? I just did all this nice stuff for you. You know what I mean? And is cleaning the kitchen and washing the dishes for your mom a nice thing to do? Yes or no? Yeah. I think it's a nice thing to do. But in the story I just told you, was I being nice? Yes or no? No, I was not being very nice. I was being really mean. I was trying to get my mom by doing something nice for her. And I think that's what Paul is talking about. We can do nice things. We can be good people. But if we don't have love in our hearts, if we don't treat people with respect and kindness, then it doesn't mean anything. Because love is what's most important. Not necessarily what we do, but how we do it. Amen? Amen. All right. So we're going to keep reading because Paul, if we stop here, we have a problem, right? Because we see that we can do nice things, but we can do them the wrong way. So what does it mean to do nice things or to do things with love in your heart? Well, Paul keeps talking about this. So we're going to keep going. Starting in verse 4, I'm going to keep reading from 1 Corinthians 13. It says this, love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. It is not boastful. It is not arrogant. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not irritable. It does not keep a record of wrongs. Love finds no joy in unrighteousness, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they'll come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. But now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. So Paul tells us right here in these verses how we can be loving people with good attitudes, how we can do the right thing with the right attitude. And Paul says, if you are being loving, if you're doing things with the right attitude, these are the things that are going to come out of you. These are the things people are going to notice in your character when you are being loving. Paul says, you will be patient. You will be kind. You will not be envious or jealous, right? You will not be boastful or proud. You will not be arrogant. You won't be rude. You won't be self-seeking or selfish. You're not going to be irritable, but you're going to be peaceful. You will not keep a record of wrongs. You won't keep looking at your friend like, remember what you did last week? I remember that, right? You will not keep a record of wrongs. You will rejoice in the truth, and you will bear, believe, and hope all things, okay? These are all the things of what it is like to be a person who has love in their heart, who loves people well in the things they do. And this is what I want you to know, is that a lot of times we think about following Jesus like, oh, I got to do the right thing so that Jesus knows that I do the right thing, right? I got to make sure that I punch my ticket, that I do all my good deeds. And good things are good, right? Like doing the right thing is good. But the truth of the matter is that the way that we do the right thing matters way more than whether or not we are doing what we're supposed to, right? That's what this whole verse is about. Have you ever heard the story of Cain and Abel? So Cain and Abel, right? Cain and Abel, they're brothers. They bring sacrifices to God. Cain brings some fruits from his garden that he's growing. Abel brings a firstborn lamb. And God looks at them both and he says, I like Abel's better. And I don't think that God likes Abel's sacrifice better because God likes sheep better than fruit or because of anything like that. I think that why God looks at Abel and says, I like your sacrifice better, is because Cain had a wicked heart. Cain did the right thing. Cain brought a sacrifice to God, but his heart was so wicked. It was so evil. And we see that because then Cain goes and kills his brother because he's so jealous of him. He kills him. And the truth is that Abel's good heart is what God liked more than the offering. God didn't care about what they brought. He cared about their hearts. God tells later in the Bible, there's a story about a prophet named Samuel, and he's choosing a king. He's choosing a king for Israel. And God tells Samuel this. He says that man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. Isn't that interesting? So tell me again, what is your theme verse for this year? Right, exactly. I'll read it again. It says, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you are also to love one another. All right? So in order to love each other, we have to not just be nice to each other or do the right thing, right? We have to really care about it, or we will literally be just as meaningless and silly as this ringing gong. Very nice, right? Very nice. So friends, we need to be kind today and we need to have love in our hearts in the way we treat each other. Because if we do the right thing until the cows come home, it does not matter unless we have love. Amen? All right, I'm going to pray for us and then we're going to wrap it up. Lord, thank you so much for today. Thank you for all these wonderful men and women who are seeking you and following you. And I'm so grateful for them. I'm so grateful for just their hearts for you. And I pray for them today as they go to class, as they go into the weekend, Lord, that they would be reminded that though they may do the right things, though they may speak in angelic tongues, they may do all these things, Lord, that if they do not have love in their hearts, they are nothing. They are a ringing gong. And so I pray that you would instill in them a love for you and a love for your commandments that would help them to honor you with everything they say and do. We are so grateful for you, Lord. We're so grateful that you died on the cross for our sin. And it is in your name we pray. Amen.
Well, thank you so much. That was a good word for us, wasn't it? Amen. Love one another. Have a good attitude. It's all about the heart. All about the